This is the companion sketch video to the pulp molded fiber wireless charging series that I'm working on. And in this video, we'll cover just the sketch and the technique that I used to create the sketch. This video is also dedicated to TeamSeas.org, where we're trying to raise $30 million to remove 30 million pounds of plastic from the world's oceans. So head on over to TeamSeas.org to make your donation today to help save your beautiful planet.
Link below in the description.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. Now, before I got to doing the sketch that you see in this video, I did a series of little thumbnail sketches in my sketchbook to work out the design and the general overall look and feel of the concept that we're going for. And this is the final thumbnail that I do before this sketch. I'm using some 32-pound bright white laser jet coated paper and a 10% cool gray marker. This is a one-point perspective with the perspective on the left-hand side, and I'm using my marker to help me just lay out and visualize the sketch to see if it's something that I'm going to like. And I actually don't, and I throw it away, and I'm going to start over. I'm going to do the same view. I just didn't like where that one was going and the proportions that I had set up and stuff, so I throw it away. I mean, there's no sense in doing the nice marker rendering if the view isn't good or the perspective isn't right or it's not what you want. Just start over. The technique that I'm using here with the marker is used by a lot of designers, and I like it. I've been using it more and more, actually. The 10% gray is intended to sort of be like your underlay sketch. So you can't see the lines very well, even in the recording here, but you can see it plenty well when it's on the paper, and they will fade away as you add more value to the paper and you build up the value of the sketch over time, and that underlay will kind of go away, but it becomes your guide and helps you set up the whole view. And I find this a really useful technique in lieu of, let's say, doing a computer sketch where you can turn the layers on and off. And this is kind of a underlay layer in that sense. And it helps me, you know, just block out the basic proportions on the page of the object that I'm working on. When I'm working on a marker sketch, I'm always working from light to dark. And I usually start with the shadow first, and this helps me anchor the object on the page, allows me to ground the object and know where my shadow is. And in this case, the shadow is a straight down shadow. Even though my light source is coming from the right across the page to the left, I do my shadow as a straight down shadow. It's just a easier way to do a shadow than spending the time calculating what the shadow is, but at least it anchors the object onto the page. And you see I even add the little shadow, almost like an ambient occlusion shadow on the cell phone against the object itself. Now we'll start adding value to the different surfaces of the object itself. I start in the back and I add value to that surface there, and then I come in and I'm going to darken in the underside of this object, which is all in shadow. So in this case, it gets pretty dark. I'm probably using a 60% gray here, something like that, just to give the underside some depth and make it fall away. And I even add a little bit of texture to sort of simulate the pulp and the rough texture that this object would have during manufacturing. There's even a little backside surface there that you can see, and that gets even darker. So now I'm doing the floor, and again, I'm trying to make it kind of blotchy, sort of the way a pulp molded fiber object is. They're not super smooth on the backside of when they're surfaced. One side often has a little bit of texture from the wire screen when it's molded, but the other side is usually pretty rough. And so I'm going to try to simulate that at least a little bit here if I can. I'm not going to go too overboard. And I'm just trying to add some contrast in between the surfaces so that you can read the form of the object. And then down here, this is where the cell phone is actually sitting on the surface of the charger. And now I'm going to work on the background to help the cell phone kind of pop and the surface of the charger pop off the page as well. And I make that darker so that I try to get some good contrast between the background and the object itself. You'll also notice that the cell phone here gets very little marker added to it. That's not really what the sketch is about. The cell phone happens to be part of the story, but it's really just a supporting character, so I don't add much value to the cell phone as I don't want it to distract from the object itself, and I just leave the cell phone the way it is, and I just let that be white and then let the object that's important have value to it so that you can understand what's going on, and you can even see a little bit of the underlay through the cell phone so you can still see the rest of the surfaces there. And then I draw in the cord, which is the wireless charging. This will have a wireless charger that you can drop in from behind and pop into the unit so that you can charge your phone while it's on the stand. So whether you add that additionally later or you just use the object the way it is to support your cell phone, you can choose what you want to do there. I'm using a gel pen here, and this is probably a 0.4 millimeters, so not super thin. A lot of times I would use maybe like a 0.25 to start with when I do a sketch, but the sketch is pretty large actually. It takes up most of the page, and I feel like using a 0.25 black outline would just be too fine and it would kind of get lost in the shuffle here. So I start with something a little bit heavier so that I can outline the objects and make them recognizable and readable on the page. I also use a straight edge to give me a nice straight edge. There's nothing wrong with that. Basically, it's a rough sketch, and I use the straight edge to just help me sweeten up the lines that are there so it looks like something that's a little bit more production-oriented, actually has some nice edges, and basically I'm sweetening up the sketch. Not everybody does this, but I find it also saves a little bit of time and just makes the drawing look a little bit neater and a little bit more professional. You'll see I draw in some double lines where there's radiuses, and I make those lines a little bit lighter, so maybe I'm using the 0.25 there just to sort of show that the form changes. And now I come back in with something a little bit heavier on the lines that are exposed, meaning they have air behind them. And on the ground plane shadow, I'm even coming in here with a Sharpie. So these lines, they're darker, they have air behind them, and they are emphasized more for the outline and to give some depth to the sketch. So in surfaces that don't have any air space behind them, those are lighter lines, and this is how you can vary your line weight to give your sketch some extra depth as we read these surface changes with the darker lines next to them as having a space behind them. Now, this sketch probably took me, I don't know, 45 minutes, an hour, something like that, and you'll see the marker has actually started to fade a little bit as it dries out, and I come back, maybe darken up some stuff to add a little bit more contrast, drop in some of these additional drop shadows from the cord and the phone onto the charger itself, and just to kind of punch up the sketch and make it read a little bit better. It's that contrast that we like as humans and helps us understand and read a sketch. So any good design sketch, I feel, really needs to have some notes to help explain little details that may not be so obvious. Maybe it's a specific type of material, tells a little bit more about the product and what it is. Maybe it's something that helps the engineers or a manufacturer to understand your concept. And so I like adding notes to a sketch, and it helps add some detail or visual detail to the sketch and just gives the viewer a little bit more information about what you were thinking when you were designing this product. Again, this is going to be a molded fiber product, kind of like the egg cartons in your refrigerator, and it's an eco-friendly, sustainable product, doesn't have any plastic, and my goal with this project is to take it from concept to prototype to show the process that I go through when I design a product. So hope you follow along and enjoyed the video. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.